Hey, blessings, prayer warriors. God bless you again on the Lord's Day. Bam, it's here already. Sunday, April 28th. Thank you again for being with me as we have our 10 minutes of prayer, be it in the morning, afternoon, or evening. Again, services today, 9 and 11. Why did Jesus come? Amen. We're going to look at that. 1 John, again, it's a powerful scripture. If we get it in us, we're going to break worry, oppression, anxiety, fear, all these things that just kind of attack us as human beings. As we continue to look up, we still know Satan knows his time is short. Therefore, he's gone cuckoo, if you know what I'm trying to say. Just look at our world. Normal isn't coming back. Jesus is. Amen. And here we're reading Luke chapter 21, verses 20 through 38. And we see over in verse 36, he goes through all the different things that are going to happen during the tribulation and stuff like that. In 36, he says, "Watch therefore and pray always that you may be counted worthy to escape all these things that will come to pass and to stand before the Son of Man." And that's what we're doing. We're having our time of watching and praying right here. Amen. So today, our prayer focus is the homeless. Our prayer focus for the nations are Costa Rica. And we're praying for West Virginia and Maryland in the States. West Virginia has 39% evangelical Christians, and Maryland has 18%. All right, we're ready. Got the prayer cards, got our prayer maps. Let's go ahead and pray today. Precious Father, we do thank you for another day. Again, this is the day the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. I thank you that we celebrate Jesus today. I thank you that we're going to come in and sing songs and worship you with hands lifted up. Worship you with a heart of praise, Lord, on this, oh my, this Sunday, last Sunday of the month, before our big conference next week, Lord. Thank you always that you're always for us, you're with us, you never forsake us, you're a good, good Abba, a good, good Father, and we say thank you, thank you, thank you for that. Father, as I begin today, I pray for my brothers and sisters. I pray that their heart would be hungry to get into church today, or if this is after church, at least watch the service online. Because we are living in a day and age that's full of anxiety, full of fear, full of worry. And I just want to see people set free. I want to be set free also. So I pray for those that are with me today. I pray blessing upon them and their families. I pray for their children, their nephews, their nieces, whatever way it is. And I thank you, Lord, for your amazing touch upon their lives, your guidance, your direction. You said to delight ourselves in the Lord, and you give us the desires of our heart. Commit our way unto you, trust also in you, and you bring it to pass. Psalm 37. You said, trust in the Lord with all your heart, and lean not onto your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct your path. Proverbs 3. I thank you for these promises. For the promises of God are yea, in him, amen. Your promises are true, Lord. So we take hold of your promises. We are living in a world that has gone into total delusion. The things we are seeing, Lord, are beyond words. We know that we're getting ready for the baby to be born, the return of our Jesus. But Lord, we're still here, so we're thanking you for your protection, your wisdom, that we won't get caught up in this culture, but that we'll stay strong in the Lord and in the power of his might, that we keep our eyes focused on you and not all that's going on out there. Of course, we need to know some of the things that are going on, but we don't need to be so caught up that it brings fear, anxiety, and worry into our lives. So I pray strength upon us, and I pray that we would renew our minds with this book that is eternal and not the news, which is just temporal. Today, Lord, as we begin to pray, we lift up the nation of Israel before you. And I have never seen anything like it. As they asked, I remember what queen it was, why she believes the Bible. And she said, because of the Jews. We just watch, why so much hatred against this one group of people? Why don't they just leave them alone? Because the devil wants to eliminate the book. If he can eliminate the book, he eliminates the Savior, the Messiah, everything else. Because Jesus was Jewish, Paul was Jewish, on and on, John and on and on. So we pray for the Jewish nation today. We also pray for the peace of Jerusalem, Lord. And I pray, Father, for this country every day, Lord, because, Lord, we have to watch ourselves as Christians that we don't get caught up in the philosophy of this age, in the lies of this age. I thank you for that, Lord. We pray for this little nation, the size of New Jersey, but hated by the world. In fact, you told us in your word that all nations will eventually go or betray Israel, but the God of Israel, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob will not betray him. We lift up the Middle East before you, and we pray also for the children of Ishmael, that they would see that they were blessed because of Abraham, and that they can have these blessings upon them if they would just reconcile with their brothers. But we know that's not going to happen while we're still here on this earth. We lift up Costa Rica before you, and we pray for this nation today, Lord. Small nation, only 5 million people, 18% evangelical Christians. We pray for them. We lift up Hong Kong. We lift up Bernice. We lift up North Korea, South Korea, Japan, Taiwan, the Philippines. We lift up our world before you. We pray for the nations, but most important, we pray for the lost, the unchurched, and the unsaved. We pray for scales to come off of people's eyes, hearts to be opened in Jesus' name. And I thank you for that, Lord. Father, we lift up the United States before you. And again, we pray, God, don't bless us anymore. God, help us. We need help to bless us with more prosperity after all the evil that we have done, the abortions, the gender stuff, and on, and spread it throughout the world, would just show a blessing upon that. I thank you that we hold back that evil by us being the light of the world, by us being the salt of this earth. But Lord, we pray, God, help America. And maybe when we pray, God bless America, in a sense, we are saying, God, help America. We pray for West Virginia today. We pray for Maryland. We pray for Biden and Harris in our executive branch. We pray for Schumer and Johnson in our legislative branch. We pray for Roberts in our judicial branch. We pray for Murphy and governors. We pray for Adams and mayors. We pray for those that are in authority right now. We also lift up this court case in New York right now with our former president, and we pray for your favor, your wisdom, and the truth to come out, Lord. The truth is what sets us free. It's all we want, Lord, is the truth. And we thank you for that. In Jesus' name. Now, Lord, we lift up the prayer cards that have come in this past week from Sunday to today. And we pray for the needs of brothers and sisters. We lift up the cards and we just thank you again that our God supplies all of our needs according to his riches and glory by Christ Jesus. I pray for those today that are battling cancer, Lord. And we just bind up that horrendous, horrible disease. And we just pray for healing in breast cancer, healing in bladder cancer, healing in prostate cancer. On and on, every part of the body. We pray for cancer cells to die in Jesus' name. We pray over ourselves. We don't always know what's going on in our bodies. We just curse any negative, abnormal type of disease. We command you to leave our bodies, even now, in Jesus' name. We also pray for marriages. We pray for children. We pray for anxieties and worries and fears, on and on, Lord. We lift up these prayer cards. Now, Lord, we lift up the different ministries today. We lift up the Timothy Initiative, Teen World Radio, Transform World, Trinity Broadcasting Network, United Bible Society, United Church of Canada, United for Missions. We lift up for you Hands of Hope, Joyce Myers Ministry, Every Home for Christ, Andrew Warmack Ministries, and Karis Bible School. Again, we lift up Jerry Seville Ministries, Lord, with the transition that they'll be going through. And I thank you for that. We lift up our church services today, Lord, 9 and 11. And we pray that people get to church, Lord. We're living in a day and age where a lot of churches are shrinking, Lord. We believe ours is growing because the word is being preached, Lord. We worship Jesus, him alone. If I be lifted up, I will draw all men unto me. So we lift up Christian Faith Fellowship Church, every member, attender, and guest today, and we pray your blessings upon them. We also lift up every church that's preaching the word of God from the east to the west, Lord. We pray that the word of God will go forth mightily today. And I thank you for this. I also lift up every outreach that would be going on today, that the word of God would go forth mightily throughout the land. And we thank you for this. Now, Lord, as we wrap up our time, we praise you again. And also we give you thanks. Thank you for the beautiful moon, the beautiful stars, the beautiful sky, the beautiful sun. Thank you for our beautiful earth. There is no planet like it, unique in every way. Thank you for the abundance of life. And most of all, thank you that our name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life, that we are going to live forever. That's why we are looking up as we are living in warp speed days, because Scripture is being fulfilled. We love you, sir. We honor the name that's above every name, the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Well, God is good. Thank you again for joining me. If you can put a thumbs up there, appreciate that. And if you can hit the share button there, appreciate that also. God bless. Have a wonderful Sunday. Hope to see many of you very soon. And those that are in other states, thank you for joining us. Please get into your local church today. If you don't have a local church, join us at 9 and 11 on Facebook, on YouTube, and also on our website. God bless.